rolling and in focus outside Belsize Park. Amongst the myriad of London Underground facts, all those little nuggets of information and stuff about the tube in my head, one of them, my favourite, is the fact that Belsize Park behind me there on the Northern Line is the only tube station with the letter Z in its name. So for today's challenge, you'll need a tube map maybe to follow on, or maybe I can inspire you to try this yourself. We will have a go in the comments. I want to know how long, what's the shortest route, or maybe the least number of stations. There's different permutations, but it's going to take me to tick off every single letter in the alphabet, and I'm starting here because it's the only Z. So, I've got to find the shortest route on the tube which ticks off all 26 letters. Note, I'm using tube stations only, no DLR or overground, and I've got to go through consecutive stations. And I'm trying to find the journey which ticks off all the letters of the alphabet using the fewest number of stations. I'll also time it as well to see how long it takes, because maybe there's an alternative challenge or two in there about how fast you can do it as well.
So I've just missed a train, but I'll start the timer when I actually depart on the first train. And by the round, it includes the Z. What I've got here, I'm going to tick off each letter as I go. So straight away, I can tick off the B, the E, the L, the S, the I, the Z. I've already done the E, the P, the A, the R, and the K. And I get the first train southbound, so we'll start at 3:17 p.m. and next will be Chalk Farm.
Yep, however you're doing this, your route must include Belsize Park, as that's the only tube station that lets you tick off the letter Z. And by starting here, I've ticked off 10 letters already. That's a great start. My intended route is to head south into Zone 1, but immediately I realise that I've got off to a bad start by getting onto a Charing Cross Branch Northern Line train instead of a Bank Branch one, and that means I'll have to change at Camden Town. My first stop is Chalk Farm. That ticks me off the C, the F, the H, and the M, and then it's time to change at Camden.
Yeah, I messed up slightly. It's telling me the first Bank Branch train is from Platform 4, so I'm going to go to Platform 4.
Camden Town gives me D, N, O, T, and W, and that means we've got only 7 letters left to tick off. A change at Euston gives us the U, but seeing as I've got to go somewhere to get the Q, I'd have always have got it that way anyway.
Houston.
Now the X could be tricky. There's only 5 stations on the tube that have that letter in its name, and the nearest is Oxford Circus, only 2 stops away, and so that becomes the next place to go.
Okay, that gets me the X. If I change the Bakerloo line, which is parallel to the Victoria line, that'll take me down and get me the G. So on the Bakerloo, we just arrived at Charing Cross. That gives us the G, tick that off. The previous stop, Piccadilly Circus, gave us the Y, tick that off. How many letters are left?
There are now just 3 letters left to get, the J, the Q, and the V. And so a quick consult of the tube map reveals that a change in embankment and then head west on the District Line will give us the 3 letters that I need. That's St James's Park, Victoria, and then Sloane Square for the finish.
I can't actually remember what time I started at, but right now it's 3:38. I will put a little clock down in the corner to see how long it's taken me as well. We're changing at embankment.
This is embankment.
The train arrives and it's all plain sailing from this point onwards. I tick off the J at St James's Park, and then here's Victoria. That gives us the V, thank you very much. And then, for the finish, we go to Sloane Square for that tricky Q. One of 4 tube stations to be something something square, but this one was the closest. So that's all 26 letters ticked off, and I passed through 13 stations and can be done using just 4 trains, I did it in 5, and I think that's unbeatable. Or is it? Time for some summing up thoughts.
Got in at 3:48 and that was my total time with Sloane Square Station behind me. I have some challenges to throw down for you. The obvious one, there's actually 3 variations here, is can you do better? As in, is there a shorter route? It's got to be contiguous, which ticks off all 26 letters, which beats what I did today in terms of number of stations. You could, of course, then also optimally try and beat it in terms of number of trains. I think you can do it in 2, maybe involving
a Circle Line train on one other, but work out what's the least number of trains you can do it in, and then maybe also try and work out what's the fastest time you can do it in, even if it's like 7, 8, 9, 10 trains. It could be like more trains, but just with the changes between, you know, short distance between stations, is there a faster time that you can do it in? Check your journey on Journey Planner for that. But then, for the ultimate nerdiness, and I know you're gonna wanna do this, there's one final thing. Again, split into two categories, and that is if you can pick any names, any tube stations only, not overground, not DLR, just underground stations out of the 272 that exist, what is the smallest number of stations? So i.e. you're not taking a journey, can you just do it like using three stations or four stations? What's the smallest number of stations that you can use? One of them has to be Belsize Park to cover all 26 letters of the alphabet. And then for the ultra nerdy challenge, total up the number of letters, like, because you might be able to say that there's 5 tube stations, but what if there was a 6 tube stations which had shorter names and a smaller total of letters in all? I realize that's really nerdy. Put your answers in the comment below, and I'm gonna go home not counting letters on the way. Thanks, bye.